Hello, collective. It's Kai. You know when you experience something so deeply dark, right? Like literally death. That has been one thing for me, and I realized like it's so important to not be jaded. I always try to brush my teeth before I do my fucking videos, but I really wanted to talk about this because jading yourself over, you know, with that mindset of like, no one can understand this feeling truly. I really felt that after my friend passed away. It's almost been 2 years now. And I was just getting a tarot read and I realized like, it's so true though. I cried, I grieved, I screamed, I wailed. Then I got physically attacked and so much volatile energy was within me. I didn't feel safe in my own home, so I left, right? If you've been following, you know. And then I met a twin flame and that fucking, it honestly was just so overstimulating and I felt even more dysregulated and discombobulated and destructive and just disastrous. I didn't really think highly of myself because of where I was at. And then I realized, you know, it's been 2 years practically. I finally really recognized that it built a lot of strength within me. Because if I hadn't gotten myself out of that place, you know, that fucking feeling of like, damn, I literally feel so fucking dreadful. And it's just so crazy because I would not have imagined that I'd be in a place of my own. You know what I mean? Like, the future is so fucking unknown. And my voice is kind of shaking because I also need to eat, but. Wait. I just want to make sure. Sorry. But genuinely, don't jade yourself freaking because of how deeply you feel. We have feelings. I have feelings. And at the same time, it has built so much strength that when there are chaotic moments of like contradictions or confrontational encounters, right? And I give credit to the past as much as releasing the past and making space. That's what I really wanted to talk about. It's like, you can't welcome in new experiences, truly new experiences that align with the developing you, the you that desires and dreams of something that lied dormant within you. So subconscious, so unknown and hidden. And I've been recognizing that a lot. Like, I've been seeing so clearly how by holding on to a person or place and even like the past experiences, it's me filling my own space with that energy, with that image, with kind of like that definition of things. When in reality, it truly isn't ever the same. And especially with having an actual like routine and like for example, things that have to be done at a certain specific time due to deadlines. Yes, that does include like paying bills and stuff like that. It allows me to ground myself, honestly, to bring myself back into this fucking physical dimension. Like, genuinely, it helps me to kind of like focus on myself even more. Which is so interesting because I'm sure there are a lot of negative perspectives on things like that. But it's just so, it's so, to me, it means less to put or like be upset or to complain about things. And yesterday I had this experience where someone was making a joke, right? And I was just like talking about my situation physically, and I haven't like physically been the best. And the way that they responded was like, you know, when like someone like goes like blah 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 blah, like, you know, stuff like that, and like taunts you a little bit, but like, even though they said it was a joke, I was like, that's so fucking cheap. Because in the end, it's like, you're not experiencing what my body's going through. So, and you're also a man. So it's like, you don't even have phases. And so physiologically, it doesn't make sense if you were to understand truly what I'm going through. So it's like one of those things where I'm not going to get upset or take it personal that someone's pretty much making fun of my situation. And it truly is having that lightheartedness and yet still being centered within myself and validating my own experience. So that's why, like, despite having that really deep, like, darkening time close to death, it doesn't mean that other people need, oh my God, I would really not fucking want anyone to go through what I went through, because that was fucking just depressing. It was so depressing. And yes, of course, there are beautiful times of light, but you know, when you're not feeling good emotionally or mentally, it literally kind of like shrouds over the experiences happening in that time. And that's why I've been focused on really learning how to emotionally regulate, and so that I could experience things just as they are, not even like more positive. It's literally just like, experience them, like let them be, experience it as it is. And yes, of course, I have my own perception based on my senses, whether I've eaten, slept well, like all these things, right? So it is really important for me to share this message, because jading yourself with that intent of like, oh, no one's going to be able to understand me, like there's no point. No, you get to experience that emotion, dude. Like, that is so fucking powerful. And that is so fucking valid as fuck. That is valid as fuck. All right. And so I just wanted to share that a little bit, because I'm feeling my flow again, guys. It's really nice. And I want to be like up to date with you guys, because time is a fucking illusion. And there are things that have been coming up, especially, I said that the new moon was happening today. It's actually happening tomorrow, I'm pretty sure. But it's in Scorpio. I'm Scorpio. It's Scorpio season, and it's Halloween today. And I really have been taking my time, allowing my process to unfold. That's like one of the most biggest things about this whole 2 year like span. Because at the same time, as much as I would love to be able to, like, to an extent, I could tap into that like past version of myself. I want to continue, because it happened. She passed away. I was in Korea beforehand, and I experienced a mass amount of deaths within the country of like my motherland country. And I saw, heard people crying, literally witnessed someone get affected by their coworker committing, I'm just gonna say it because I know that might be triggering, but honestly, it has to be talked about. But like, the mental health education is so sparse in Korea, and this person experienced their coworker committing suicide. And so I've just been really reevaluating a few things, because you know when like that one thing keeps coming up and you're like, what the fuck, like I don't even know like why I'm so drawn to this, you know, it's like one of those things. And I do feel like it's kind of telling me a little bit more about where I want to put my energy in, because my race is literally dwindling because of the boycott against the patriarchy. And also, the capitalism is so fucking blatant in Korea. But I don't want to go into that right now, honestly. It's already fucking draining. But seriously, like, honor yourself, honor your process, honor your emotions, honor your deaths, honor that darkness that you went through, honor the light that you showed yourself moving out of it. Honor, like, the self-respect, the diligence, the discipline, okay? The discipline, doing it even though you really fucking didn't want to. Like, going to work when you really fucking don't want to. And then you go to work and then something good happens and you're like, what the fuck? Thank God I came to work today. Today? Sorry, I'm hungry. Yeah, that is it. Thank you so much for being here. Seriously. Thank you for being you. Thank you for being every single part of you, every single part of you that's developing, every single part of you that you're now becoming. Thank you. Thank you for being fucking alive and choosing yourself today. Okay? I'm sending you guys so much love and support on your own spiritual journey. Bye, guys.